Yeah, good morning, student. Today we are going to discuss about the lecture number 31, and the topic is schizophrenia. So, what is schizophrenia? It is a psychotic disorder which mainly includes hallucination, delusion, disruption of normal logic and thought process, that is, split mind. That is splitting of perception and interpretation from reality. So the word schizo means split, phrenia means mind, split mind, and it should not be confused with split personality. Split personality is a different thing, split mind is a different thing. Split mind is a schizophrenia, and it includes important symptoms like hallucinations and delusion and disruption of normal logic and thought process. So what is hallucination and what is delusion? Hallucination is actually the sensation which is actually not there, and that sensation may be visual or auditory, but the patient is feeling that something is there, like audible or visual sensation, which is actually not present. But if patient in schizophrenia starts feeling that there is something, okay, so that is called hallucination. Hallucination is also, you can say, it is a false perception, whereas delusion is a false belief. So false perception is hallucination and false belief is delusion. So false perception, it can be auditory or visual. Delusions is a false belief, and person feel very strong about something even if evidence is given, is not ready to accept. So delusions of control, as for example, where a patient feel that some outside forces is controlling the patient, that is called delusion of control. Then delusion of reference. In this, the patient feel that some people are talking about you. Okay, even in your friend circle, if 2-3 friends are talking, so you'll be start thinking that they are talking about you only. So that is called delusion of reference. And even you can go to your home and you can complain to your parents that everybody is talking about me only. So that is called delusion of reference. So the important symptoms of schizophrenia is hallucination and delusion. Hallucination is false perception and delusion is false belief. And there is a disruption of normal logic and thought process. So there will be disturb normal way of thinking, and there is a splitting of perception. So what is perception? It is the ability to see, to hear, or become aware of something through the sense. So that ability to see, hear, and aware of something through the senses is called perception. So that is also going to split and disturb. And interpretation from reality. So what is interpretation? That is the action of explaining the meaning of something. So you are going to explain something which is not the real. So that is called interpretation from reality. Schizophrenia types. There are 5 types of schizophrenia. Paranoid schizophrenia. Here the patient suffer from strong delusion and hallucination. So here the symptoms that is delusion and hallucinations, it will be of strong severity. Second is called hemiphrenic or disorganized schizophrenia. In this, the patients are confused and there is disorganized pattern of speech, thought and behavior. So in this, your speech, your thought and your behavior is all disorganized. What you are thinking and what you are behaving is not matching, and what you are telling is all are not matching. matching. So that is a disorganized pattern of speech, thought and behavior. So that is called as epiphrenic or disorganized schizophrenia. Third type is called as a catatonic schizophrenia, and it is characterized by abnormal types of posture and movement. So when it is abnormal posture and movement, so that is the word related with tone, that is catatonic schizophrenia. Fourth type is called undifferentiated schizophrenia. This type of patients show symptoms of schizophrenia but do not fit into the above categories. Means here the patient does not belong to paranoid, epiphrenic and catatonic schizophrenia. So they show the symptoms but it is not belonging to any of the above three. So that is called undifferentiated schizophrenia. Then you have a residual schizophrenia. Here the patient show only one type of schizophrenic episodes, but there is no severity of symptoms as seen as in above three types. So patients show only one types, but this symptom is not so severe. That is called residual schizophrenia. So there are five types of schizophrenia: paranoid, epiphrenic, catatonic, undifferentiated, and residual schizophrenia. The next is etiology. What is the reason of our schizophrenia? It may be related with the genetic, any gene abnormalities. Then second is the imbalance of the neurotransmitter in the brain can result in schizophrenia. Mostly there is two important neurotransmitter, dopamine and serotonin. So in schizophrenia, what is going to happen is the level of dopamine and serotonin is going to increase in the brain, in a special specific region of the brain. So when dopamine and serotonin levels will increase, it can lead to schizophrenia. Then third is brain damage. Because of the brain damage, enlargement of ventricles. The ventricles, we know that it is lateral ventricle, third ventricle. So this is actually the space in the brain where the cerebrospinal fluids flow. So if that ventricles is going to enlarge, or if there is widening of cerebral fissures, so in the brain, if the fissures is going to become wide, then it causes schizophrenia, and it generally happens in viral infection, the infection caused by the virus. So this is the this can lead to schizophrenia. The next is environmental influences affect the brain in early stage of life or during pregnancy. So during pregnancy or during the early stage of life in babies, small baby, so there is a lot of environmental changes that can also affect the brain and can lead to schizophrenia. Then viral attacks also causes schizophrenia. So these are the some etiology of schizophrenia. Then symptoms are generally there is emotional disorder, impairment in behavior, thinking, impairment in behavior and thinking. Then delusion and hallucination. Delusion is a false belief and hallucination is false perception. The patient is emotionally cut off from the world. Thought broadcasting, he starts thinking many things. Then external control of emotions, and the patient start thinking that some external force is controlling him. The patient believes that thoughts and acts are due to influence of other. So the patient start thinking whatever he is thinking and whatever he is acting is because of some other person, that is due to the influence of others. So generally in life we get influenced by other, but this schizophrenia patients, they are most influenced by the other. Generally, the symptoms of schizophrenia is categorized into three groups. That is positive symptoms, negative symptoms, and cognitive symptoms. So what is positive symptoms? Are those symptoms where no normal physiology exists. Means before this symptoms there is no normal states, normal physiology, whereas in negative symptoms there is before these symptoms there is a normal function, normal physiology, that is called as negative symptoms. Like if you take a lack of interest in one surrounding, so before that what was that? There was interest in one surrounding, so that is a normal condition. Now it converted into lack of interest in one surrounding, so that is called negative symptoms. So for these negative symptoms there is a normal physiology functions, normal state exist, whereas for positive symptoms there is no normal physiology state, normal state does not exist. So it comes directly as a symptoms of schizophrenia. So positive symptoms is hallucination, delusion, disorganized behavior. So hallucination, again it is a false perception. Delusion is a false belief. Disorganized behavior. Disorganized behavior means it's like the behavior which is having no purpose, meaningless behavior. Like in some patients suffering from schizophrenia, they wear a jacket in summer. So that is not a meaningful behavior. So that is called disorganized behavior. Then agitation, then brain structure and functions are normal, but the disorder is due to the dopaminergic transmission. So in schizophrenia, the brain structure and function is going to be normal, but what is the problem is that dopaminergic transmission is going to get affected. Here in positive symptoms, the patient shows a good response to neuroleptic drugs. Means the drugs which is used for the treatment of psychiatric patients is called neuroleptic drugs. So the person having positive symptoms is good treated by neuroleptic drugs. Whereas negative symptoms, there is a normal state initially, and that converted into the abnormal state, that is negative symptoms of schizophrenia. The first is called apathy. What is apathy? It is a lack of interest in one surrounding. Before he was interested, when he was normal, when schizophrenia starts, he become is not taking interest in surrounding. Lack of motivation. Before he was motivated, but because of schizophrenia now there is a lack of motivation. Then social withdrawal. Before that he was doing well, mingle with the society, he was having friendship or behavior. After getting this schizophrenia, he is becoming social withdrawal. He starts staying alone, not mingling with the society. Then emotional unresponsiveness. Now emotionally also is not responding. Suppose emotional unresponsiveness, suppose some monkey came inside your house and he is throwing the things here and there and you are not giving any response, that is emotional unresponsiveness. The brain does not function normally. So in this the positive symptoms, the brain was structure and function was normal, but in negative symptoms the brain does not function normally. The patient shows a poor response to neuroleptic drugs. So this neuroleptic medicines is not well treated these negative symptoms. And the third is called cognitive dysfunction. Means the patient of schizophrenia have abnormalities in attention, working, memory and executive function. So their attention, their working memory and executive functions is all going to become abnormal. So mainly the symptoms of schizophrenia, the main thing is to remember positive symptoms, negative symptoms and cognitive dysfunction. So here also you can see positive symptoms, negative symptoms, cognition and mood symptoms. So this is again the symptoms of schizophrenia. Positive symptoms: hallucination, delusion, disorganized thought, perception disturbances, inappropriate emotions. So these are the positive symptoms. Negative symptoms are blunted emotions, anhedonia, and lack of feeling. Cognitive, there is a new learning memory. Mood symptoms: loss of motivation, social withdrawal, anxiety and demoralization, and suicidal attempt. So these all are the symptoms of schizophrenia. Then pathogenesis of schizophrenia. So for pathogenesis of schizophrenia, you can write one important point that dopamine and serotonin is two important neurotransmitter which play a very important role in schizophrenia. And in schizophrenia, what I mean, there is imbalance in these two neurotransmitters, and actually both the level of dopamine and serotonin increase during the schizophrenia, and because of that it is causing hallucination and delusion. So this is the showing how the synthesis of dopamine take place from tyrosine, that is the amino acid, and how serotonin, that is also called as 5-hydroxytryptamine, is getting synthesized from amino acids called tryptophan. After that, for the flow chart for pathogenesis, we can explain this flow chart, where the first is genetic, that is 50% monozygotic twin risk, and 6 to 13% first degree relative risk. So genetic, 50% in twins, and 6 to 13% if you are a relative. Dopamine hypothesis, that is the most important and predominant theory which explain the pathogenesis of schizophrenia, and some other biological theories under still under investigation. So this all is going to lead schizophrenia, where there is abnormalities of neurotransmitter, mainly dopamine transmission in the various regions of the brain, and even there is high expressed emotions if the patient is living in environment with extensive negative comments expressed toward the patient, then the chances of relapse, chances of getting schizophrenia is becoming more because of staying in the negative environment. So if there is abnormality, there is can be of two types of abnormality in the dopaminergic transmission. One is increased dopaminergic transmission in mesolimbic projection. So there is a region in the brain that is called mesolimbic area. So there, if the dopaminergic transmission is going to increase, then dopaminergic neurons here project into the limbic system, is actually the responsible for behaviors and emotions, and this leads to abnormal dopamine transmission. Is here is thought to cause the positive symptoms of schizophrenia. So positive symptoms of schizophrenia is because of the increased dopaminergic transmission in mesolimbic area, because this is the dopamine in mesolimbic area is responsible for behavior and emotion. So if this transmission is going to increase, So if this dopaminergic transmission in this mesolimbic area is going to increase, then that is the results in the positive symptoms of schizophrenia. And we know that what is positive symptom of schizophrenia, it is those symptoms for which there is a normal there is no normal state, no normal previous physiology exist. That is delusion, hallucination, speech disorganization or senselessness, and grossly disorganized motor behavior. So delusion, fixed false beliefs out of keeping with cultural background. Hallucination is sensation without stimuli. There is no actually auditory and visual things present, but still the patient is feeling something is there, usually auditory in schizophrenia. Then speech disorganization or senselessness, that is tangentiality, derailment, and word salads. So what is tangentiality? It is the tendency to speak about unrelated topics. So that is called as tangentiality. They are speaking something which is not related with the topics. And derailment. Derailment is nothing but interruption, that is frequent interruption in thought process. So that is called derailment. And word salads is actually confused or unintelligible mixture of words and phrases. So you are not able to use the word and phrases with intelligence. That is the confused or unintelligible mixture of random words and phrases is called as word salad. Then grossly disorganized motor behavior, including catatonia, unresponsive to environment. So this is all the positive symptoms which is taking place because of the increased dopaminergic transmission in mesolimbic area. Whereas if there is a decreased dopaminergic transmission in one of the region of the brain, that is called as mesocortical projection, then dopaminergic neurons here project into the cerebral cortex, that is the frontal lobes, responsible for thinking, decision making, language production and mood. So this dopaminergic neurons is projected into the cerebral cortex, that is the frontal lobe specially, which is responsible for your activity like thinking, decision making, language production and mood. So this is all going to disturb because of the decreased dopaminergic transmission, and this leads to abnormal dopaminergic transmission. Here is thought to cause negative symptoms of schizophrenia. So this is the negative symptoms of schizophrenia, that is diminished emotional expression, affecting flattening is actually a reduction in the range and intensity of emotional expression, including facial expression, means you are not giving any facial expression. Then next is alogia. So alogia means it is alogia. Alogia means complete lack of speech. Abolition means decrease in the motivation to initiate and perform some of the self-directed purposeful activities. So that decrease in the motivation is called as abolition. Then diminution of thought, that is decrease of thought. And asociality. Asociality means you are cut off from the society, you are staying alone, you are not taking interest in the society. So this is the pathogenesis of schizophrenia, which starts with the genetics and dopamine hypothesis. and this leads to the abnormality of neurotransmitter, mainly dopamine, in various regions of the brain. So one reason is mesolimbic region, and other reason is mesocortical region. And if dopaminergic transmission is going to increase in mesolimbic region, then it leads to the positive symptoms of schizophrenia. And if dopaminergic transmission is going to decrease in mesocortical region of the brain, then it leads to the negative symptoms of schizophrenia. Yeah, you can see here I have marked some word, that is hallucinations, that is a sensation actually not there, and this sensation can be auditory or visual. Disorganized behaviors means bijare, no purpose, that is wearing jacket in summer. Delusions are false belief. So person feel very strong about even if evidence is given, that is a delusion of control, that is some outside force is controlling you, then delusion of reference, some people are talking about you. Then hallucination is false perception and delusion is false belief. So that is the main symptoms of schizophrenia. Thank you.